In November 2014, the city of Berkeley, California passed a penny per ounce excise tax on sugar-sweetened beverages, the first tax of its size and type in the United States. The tax was intended to raise revenue for programs that improve children's health and to improve all Berkeley residents' nutrition by encouraging people to buy fewer taxed sugary beverages and more untaxed drinks like plain water or other unsweetened milks, juices, or teas. Beverages with added sugars that are now taxed include regular sodas, energy drinks, sports drinks, sweetened juice drinks and flavored waters, and ready-to-drink sweetened coffees and teas. As more cities around the U.S. and countries around the globe pass similar sugary drink taxes, it's important to look at what people are buying and drinking after taxes go into effect, as well as changes in beverage prices, store revenues, and customer spending to see if taxes are working as intended. That's exactly what this study did in Berkeley by comparing data from before and after tax collection began in March 2015. In its first year, the nation's first large sugar-sweetened beverage tax led to increased sugary drink prices in many store settings. It led to decreased sales of taxed sugary drinks in Berkeley without affecting overall beverage sales volumes, and average customers' grocery bills did not increase. This is all promising for the tax policy. Declines in sugary drink sales combined with new revenue generated to use for local health programs could contribute significantly to keeping Berkeley area residents healthy. To learn more about this study, follow this link to check out the full article in PLOS Medicine.